Welcome to episode 49 of World of Warcraft. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and today, you'll notice, well, let me show you. I am almost all the way to completed with Darnassus. We've got 20,353 out of 21,000. So what I'm going to do, we're going to do the last couple of quests here that I have for Darnassus, and that should take us all the way. So that's one of the quests. We're going to fold the vial. We need to kill some of these harpy guys. Shaded Kaldurai says, over time, Stagum only grew more disconnected from our people. That would be Fandral, Stagholm. Where are these harpy guys? I kept seeing them because I ended up doing a bunch of dungeon runs, which is one of the reasons why I didn't actually record. But I kept on seeing them as I passed up and down this way to sell stuff. Like, I have a whole raft of things I need to sell. Okay. Yeah, I know. I'm at the money cap, I'm aware. You will be easy prey, Mage, except not really, because I'm killing you with no trouble at all. Imagine that. But then again, these are like level 6, level 9.
I need a target.
One other thing that I managed to sort out was that my dungeon
I do not have a
user
target.
Interface was a bit of a mess, and I managed to fix that. So good things happened while I wasn't actually playing, or wasn't actually showing you what I was doing.
I need to target something first.
But the whole point here today is to make sure that even if we don't get the mount, that we get real close. Oops. Okay. And the other thing that we need to do is this old respinnerets thing. I need to find a good spot to actually farm wool cloth, and I'm not sure where to do that. I've gotten a little more wool cloth than the last time you saw, because the dungeon runs provided me a little wool cloth, but it wasn't a great amount, and doing them that way would be a little bit crazy.
I need a target.
Because we've got to go from 75 to 100 with tailoring, and that is going to require a fair bit of wool cloth. Oh, don't get thee behind me. You're not Satan, you're a harpy. Yeah. I also picked up a couple of other patterns while we were out in the wild. Or, not really out in the wild, while I was out busy doing dungeons. And that was pretty cool. So we've got a couple more leatherworking patterns, and leatherworking we can't do until we've taken away the starter edition part of this account. Because the way leatherworking would work is I need
to target
leatherworking tools
first.
And I don't have those. Because for leatherworking you need skinning, and I didn't take skinning. Where is this? Let's go grab that as well. So we can turn all this in at once. Because these two guys are right here, so I may as well just get it over with and sort it out. I did enough reading to know that the number of quests that we're doing now will take us into Exalted. And that's all I really want. What is that thing over there? I don't think I can do anything with it. More sign of the corruption, really, and told us all. Fortunately, I'm very high level, so I can basically just skip past these people. Thank goodness for that. Oops. I say that. I pick up combat. Someone's gonna ankle bite me now. It's going to be fantastic. Actually, I should blink out of the way. Okay, so there's supposed to be... Oh, there we go. Lady Sora, who is now infected. Which is kind of sad. Okay, that sorts that out. Now we can turn all this back in. The important quest here is the vial filling quest, because that will lead to a chain that we can do that will actually solve all of our reputation problems once and for all. And that will lead to us getting the mount.
I am honored.
Their slashing talons and piercing beaks may prove a difficult match for your own abilities, but I have faith that you will not fail in this task. What do you mean? Are you kidding? Is there something wrong here? The Enchanted Glade. I'm impressed that you have accomplished what you have accomplished here in so short a time. Would that I would ask you to remain here to assist me with my duties. But I know in my heart that greater tasks lie ahead for you. Oh yes, I should pick something, right? None of this is useful. Not at all. So this is gonna get me a little more money.
Good luck, friend.
And as you can see, I'm getting a little bit more Darnassus reputation, which is fantastic.
I am honored.
I regret the task that I ask you to carry out, but Lady Sathra is beyond hope. It is our hope to offer the sacrifice of the spinneret to Elune. With the sacrifice, Elune will bless Sathra so that she might be reborn and at peace. Ah, actually that's kind of sad. The forest mourns for Lady Sathra, but it was something that had to be done. I hope now that she can rest in peace. Thank you. You're
go
welcome.
In peace.
There we go, 350. And there's the spider, Lady Sathra. That's pretty cool. It's probably gonna vanish at some point. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so that's enchanting. Enchanting supplies, I don't need any of that. What I really want to do though is go and turn in my other quest. Because if you'll recall, the guy said, you know, he'll be waiting outside of Darnassus. And so we will go and do that. I got a shiny new staff as well. Out of my dungeon runs. But I mean, I was doing Rage by Chasms and... what was I doing? Rage by Chasms, specifically in Dead Mines a lot, so that I wouldn't get ahead of you guys and you would miss dungeons, because that would be unfair, so... And during the course of that, because those are pretty low-level dungeons, I just managed to sort of grab a couple of things out of there that were useful. And one of them happened to be a new scepter. There we go. Emberweave staff, level, item level 20. In fact, I can still trade it for the next 14 minutes because I logged out almost the second I got to this point here after doing several dungeon runs across kind of 2 days. I should actually talk about that, by the by. So when you do a dungeon run, anything that you pick up in the dungeon run, you can trade to anyone in the run at all, as long as they're part of the run. They can be from any realm, but you can only pass those things to each other. You can't pass money or anything. So that is why this blue text is at the bottom. You may trade this item with players that were also eligible to loot this item for the next 13 minutes. Right.
Peace be with you.
Tel'drassil, the burden of the Kel'Dorei. To be in the presence of the Oracle Tree, it is almost to feel wisdom take form. Along with the Druids, the Oracle Tree has been carefully monitoring the growth of Tel'drassil. Observations have been disheartening, but all is not without hope. The tree is indeed recovering since its blessing, but the growth is still somehow stunted. We suspect some portion of the corruption remains within the tree, waiting to be cleansed. We simply need to find it. Okay. There is one last moon mold that I would like you to visit. It is directly south of here, on the shores of the pools of Aralusin. Be wary as you seek out the well, and keep your weapons close at hand. I sense a growing corruption from the bowels of southern tel'drassil. When you have the water, I want you to bring it to a familiar face that you will see at the pools. She wishes to battle the corruption, and has asked for you personally.
Farewell.
Okay. I kind of like how they make it a mystery as to who you're going to bring the water to. So this one's way down south. There's a little pool over here. Incidentally, we're playing during the daytime for a rare change. Mostly because I need to record a couple of sessions of this in one after the other succession. But also because we need to get back to being day people, because hopefully the plan is we're going to go to a happier zone. Not that there is such a thing for the Alliance, I'm afraid. There we go, pulls Arlethan. I'm probably mispronouncing that. Arlethan or something. It's a Night Elf name. Only Night Elves will know. Oh, speaking of that. Since we're watching someone go by on this, but we mount. We should mount up too. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. I don't mind entering combat. Where is this guy? There. Okay. Shoulder The shade of Tel'drassil says, in weeks past, all of these living atop tel'drassil found their memories blurry as time itself succeeds the portion of their lives. We break from this haze to find that Fandor Stagholm and many of his closest followers have disappeared without a word. But in his place, Shandro Stormrage awoke from a dream and returned to his beloved Tyrant Whisperland. And with this return came Alexstrasza and Ysera to, at long last, offer their blessings upon tel'drassil. Though a small corruption lingers, desperately longing to be cleansed, the bones of tel'drassil itself seem changed. Growth has begun anew. None know what to expect next, but with Malfurion and Tyrande reunited, a new hope dawns in the Kaldwai. Hope for lasting relief from the shadow that has been cast on our people for so long. Okay, so, these are little stories that you're supposed to have followed from, if you were a Night Elf, you would have taken an original vial and they would have told you these stories. So, let me just put some of this into context for you. Fandor Stagholm was one of the main, druids in Night Elf society. And they vanished, I don't remember where they went. I have a feeling that they might have gone north to Northrend, but I'm not sure. Anyway, so when the Kaldwai woke up, the Kaldwai is the elven name for elves. Shandro Stormmage woke from the dream and returned to his beloved Tyrande Whisperland. Okay, so this here, Shandro, is a kind of nice name for Malfurion. This is the elf name for him. They were in the Emerald Dream, and they came back. They woke up from the Emerald Dream, and he went to Tyrande, who he's in love with, basically. Alexstrasza and Ysera are both dreams, both dragons, and in World of Warcraft, each dragon, there are a handful of really big ones. They are part of a flight. And a flight has a color. So, like, for example, the big bad in this particular Cataclysm setting was the Black Dragon. And he was not a really happy camper. These guys, the dragons, were set up to kind of protect Azeroth as a whole, but then became corrupted over time. So Ysera and Alexstrasza are two of the dragons that came and blessed the wedding of Malfurion and Tyrand, and that helped cleanse tel'drassil. Okay. Right, so we know about the little corruption that has been going inside of tel'drassil for the last little while. And that is that. So that's full as well. Okay, now we need to head backward. Where is this person? There we go. This is Tyrandrella.
Hi.
It is good to see you again. I see you have succeeded in collecting the waters of the Moonwells on behalf of Corinthus Moonraid. I hope that you have learned much along the way. Indeed. The coming dawn. Tel'drassil, the coming dawn. I have spoken to Corinthus on my way here, and he has gifted me with the waters you have been gathering. They may well prove useful sooner than we'd imagined. Strangely, the growing corruption we've felt is actually a good sign. Tel'drassil has been burdened with this taint for a long time, and thanks to the blessing of the dragon aspects, only now is it coming to the surface in a form that we might strike against. There we go. Oh, I should look at that. Hold on. Somebody likes me. Oh, I got that for getting a bunch of reputations. Raise a reputation to exalted. Right.
Is there trouble?
As tel'drassil purges itself from the corruption that has perverted its growth all these years, a malevolent growth has formed near the tree's edge. South of here, we have an opportunity to strike out and purge the source of foul moss that has tainted the gnarl pine, the timberlings, and everything else. With the water that you've collected from the moon wells and renewed strength of tel'drassil itself, I can grant you a great power for a short while. Put an end to this corruption. Use the power that's granted to you by Tyrandrella and fight your way to harder corruption and destroy it. Okay, I'll be able to pick these four things, but they're not useful at all. Okay, so I get new spells at my disposal. And I will look at them, don't worry. We just need to get where we're going, because I don't know if this sticks around. Oh, it doesn't have a timer. Well, that's good. Oh, yay, explore tel'drassil. I didn't know that was possible. Quite frankly. I'm just running, that's terrible. I get the feeling I'm supposed to be fighting all these things, but I just wander over to the source of the corruption. Assuming I can find it. Oh, you know what? It might be here. There we go. That's probably it there. Okay, moonlight.
On the sky. I am out of range.
Oh, really? Okay. Star of all, I should
that read is
these.
Still retarded.
Right. Tidal pull. That's the bow of corruption. Oh,
that
wow.
Spell is not ready yet.
No one really likes me. Okay. So having done that, we're going to find our way back. I'm gonna mount up. Oh, I can't mount up, can I? An ally of nature has come to my aid. Anyway, so that's basically the big story of tel'drassil, all essentially completed. I don't think that this ever actually properly cleanses tel'drassil, but I think it goes a long way to helping. As far as I recall. Now you'll notice that I've got 274 of 16,000. Oh sorry, that's my experience bar. I've got 178 of 1,000. And that is the last tier that you ever have in a reputation, is the exalted tier. At this point, I can probably go and buy the mount, and I'm going to do exactly that. But this is it. If I was going for completion, I would finish that off, and I'm going to actually do that because I'm very bad at things like that. I don't like seeing, like, you've got a little more to go. So I will probably fix that. Because this isn't going to get us all the way. It's going to get us a lot of the way. Balloon be praised. Everything I had encountered suggested this corruption to be buried deep within tel'drassil itself. I'd worried we might never be able to strike at the source without killing the wall tree. I'm thankful I was wrong. Ophirion was the start to this great turn of fortune. Perhaps I will seek him out before he departs for the before I depart for the wilds again. Thank you. Thank you for everything you have done. You're sure to be a great hero someday. And I can pick... I'm gonna pick that. Okay, you don't get any experience or reputation for this, but you do get it for the last one. But what's the tel'drassil? Tasks are done here for now. The water proved to be of great importance, but it wasn't originally meant for me. Go ahead and bring it back to Corinthus at the crossroads. I'm sure he'd like you to deliver it to its original destination. Okay. I will certainly do that. I'm not crazy about the Night Elves, but I like this particular story. And I like it purely because it's sort of dealing with not necessarily their mortality, but the way they kind of screwed up their own tree, you know, and I kind of like that. As I say, I'm not terribly crazy about the Night Elves, but they have a cool mount, and that's what matters. Oh, goodness. He is up the road over here.
Listening.
It is good to see you again. I sense the tel'drassil's task went smoothly with you by her side. Thank you for returning to me so swiftly. I have but one last task to ask of you. Shall we? And we shall. Oh, I need to pick one, don't I? Wow, 392. We'll take that. And I got 250 quests completed. Thank you, Doc Shaw. Oh, Mother Calderai, it has been an undeniable honor to have met you. You are a testament to the nobility of your race. Go now and finish the final task. Take the waters to Tyrande Whisper and the Darnassus. I will do that. Again, unfortunately, this isn't actually going to get me all the way to Exalted, but it's okay. We're going to stop off, we're going to finish this, we're going to buy the mount, and then I'm going to put myself into a dungeon and I'm going to get us all the way there. And then once I've got us all the way there, I'm going to show you what you generally do once you finish with the reputation. So there will be a slight pause over here. I remember that she lived in a little hut all by herself with all the other little priest people off on the left-hand side. So we've got to get ourselves there. I don't remember the layout of tel'drassil well enough to get us there without falling into the water, probably. But we'll see what we can do. Oh wait, you know what, I can probably go here. Oh, hey, there's a quest there, really? Oh, the Darkmoon Fair. I should actually really show you the Darkmoon Fair. When's it ending today? Actually, yeah, what I'll do, the next thing we'll do is the Darkmoon Fair. Very quickly, I'll just show it off to you. We'll spend a fun half an hour in the Darkmoon Fair. Where is Upwood? I seem to... There we go. I can see it now. One thing that does bother me a little is that when you go into buildings, you lose your mount. You don't lose your mount. Your mount sort of switches off, and you can only walk in places like this. I get it. They don't want to clutter the buildings with giant mounts and all that kind of thing, but it is a little bit frustrating. There we go, that's Malfurion and Tyrant.
I heed the voice of Elune.
How fare you, young one? The blessed waters from our moon walls. You have borne witness to the spirit of the Kaldari, then. In recent times, I come to find the spirit offers more questions than it does answers. But such is the continuing nature of discovery that drives us in our darkest hours. I will offer you the simplest of answers that I can. Malfurion has returned to me, to us. But harsh times are yet upon us. Stagholm is gone, and the world is racked with pain. Orfurion is much to mend, and he will need help. There we go. And that is that. That is the story of the Kaldari. Oof. I was a bit worried there that I was going to fall to my death. In fact, we're supposed to be going out this way, aren't we? I'm going to get us there just in time, aren't I? Oh, goodness. Blink. And ride. I hope I remember where that little enclave was, because it was an awkward, weird part of the city. I think it was across here. Let's see if I can get there without falling into the drink. I should be so lucky, right? Right. There we go. So now, since we have the exalted reputation, instead of getting the talk option, I'm getting the actual buy option.
My goods are of the highest.
And we have Striped Knight Saber, we have Frost Saber, we have Striped Dawn Strider, and we have the Spotted Frost Saber. What we were going to pick was... We're going to pick the... Black one, the Knight Saber, riding a striped Knight Saber. Yeah. Yep, I think we're gonna pick that one. Right, so.
I am on.
Grab the Knight's. There we go. Now you can buy all of these. God, I mean, in the long run, that is probably what you would want to do if you were mount collecting, but I just want the one.
I cannot learn that spell.
What? I already know Striped Knight Saber. Oh, I probably do, you know? I do, actually. And the reason why I know these, incidentally, is because when you flip from Horde to Alliance, it finds the nearest match. And I probably own this equivalent on the Horde side. So this is what it looks like. There we go. It's much smaller and sleeker than the turtle. But there we go. I should actually sell the actual mount back to the vendor because I already own it. I should have checked for that before, but it's all good. Right, so let's sell this back.
Peace be with you.
Yeah, there we go. And I got my money back for that, which is fine.
A loon light your path.
Right. There we go. That is the striped lightsaber. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been Leveling in World of Warcraft. I will see you next at the Dark Moon Fair. Actually, we'll finish off the reputation, then I'll see you at the Dark Moon Fair. So next episode, I'll show you all that. Have a great evening, folks. Goodbye.